working on a project where I'm trying to envision all the possible ways my life might be in the next 40 or 50 years.
I've come to see the fortune teller.
I understand you're in this quest, but there's some aspects of self-sabotage, and your thoughts just tend to get in the way.
This new venture of his was, I thought, the worst idea still that he had ever had.
Mr. Toledano, as he prefers to be known, is perhaps the most self-absorbed person I've ever met. Is that a bad thing? Not in his case, he wears it very well.
This project is about his fantasy coming together with his fears.
I'm reenacting a lot of what I did with my dad over the last few years before he died. The idea of the future was very bleak for me.
I was frightened of it because I thought, oh God, what if he finds something and it eats away at him?
I don't want to live in fear. I don't want to think about those possibilities. And I don't want to deny that they might exist either. I'm just running at them head first.
This is the one project I asked him not to pursue. And it's the one that he's kind of gone on full battalion.
You all right? Not too cold?
No.
All right.
Every day there's more possibilities that kind of unearth themselves.
When people look at those pictures and they say this seems unlikely, nothing's unlikely.